हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लर्नर्स प्लैनेट। फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज आवर सेकंड सेशन फॉर एलिगेशन एंड मिक्सचर। आई होप यू मैट हैव रिवाइज द प्रीवियस सेशन एंड यू मस्ट बी लाइकिंग द टेक्निक ऑफ एलिगेशन एंड मिक्सचर। फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड जस्ट रेकमेंड यू टू गो फॉर द बेसिक सेशंस ऑफ परसेंटेज, रेशियो एंड प्रपोर्शन एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस बिफोर यू प्रोसीड फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन। And definitely you must be having your paper and pen with you and you'll be solving the problems with me. So let's take the first problem of the day. In this question, a mixture of 20 kilograms of spirit and water contains 10% water. How much water must be added to this mix to raise the percentage of water to 25%? Friends, we are having 10% water with us. That means a mixture which is containing 10% water. And we wish to have a mixture which contains 25% of water. That means we have to add water to it. Now, in pure water, the water content is 100%. That means to increase the water content to 25%, we need to mix pure water. And what is the percentage of pure water in pure water? That is 100%. Okay. It's 15, it is 75. So it is 5:1. Now this portion, that is the 10% mixture, is containing, actually it is 20 kilogram. That means this 5 is 20. That means 1 is 4. That means for every 5 part of this spirit, 1 part of pure water should be added. That means for 20 kilograms, we need to add 4 kilograms of water. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this question. Vessel A contains milk and water in the ratio 4:5 and vessel B contains the same in the ratio 5:1. In what proportion should quantities be taken from A and B to form a mixture in which milk and water are in the proportion 5:4? Friends, we are having three ratios over here. So first of all, we have to take either milk or water ratio in each container. Okay, so in this container, and that means in vessel A, what is the what is milk's proportion? That is 4:9. It is vessel A, it is vessel B. So milk proportion is 4:9. In vessel B, milk proportion is 5:6. Okay, and what is our requirement? In the final mixture, the milk and water should be in the ratio 5:4. That means out of 9 parts, milk must be 5 part. So it's 5:9. Now we can find out the ratio. Here it is 5:6 minus 5:9. And here it is 5:9 minus 4:9. So it is 5:18 and it is 1:9, or we can say 2:18. That means the ratio is 5:2. Okay, so from A 5 part and from B 2 part should be taken to get this mixture. I hope you are clear. And alternatively, you can take, as I have taken the milk part in this method, you can take even water part. And similarly, you can solve the problem. Okay. Friends, a similar problem. I would recommend you to pause the session and try the problem on your own and then match your answer and solution with mine. Okay. Now two casks, suppose X and Y, contain mixture of liquid A and B. In the first cask, A is to be 7:3, and in the second cask, A is to be 3:1. In what ratio must the mixtures from the two casks be taken to give a mixture in which A is to be is 11:4? Now, cask X, cask Y. Now, further, we'll be taking the one of the liquids part. In this, that means the cask X, the total part is 10, and out of that 10 part, 7 part is liquid A. Okay, so we'll be making the comparison of liquid A only. In this, that is the cask Y, is having 3/4 part. And in our final mixture, we want A to be 11 by 15. Okay. So just solve it. So let's calculate it. 11 by 15 minus 7 by 10 and 3 by 4 minus 11 by 15. So 11 by 15 minus 7 by 10 will give us 1 by 30. And this calculation will give 1 by 60. Or we can say it is 2 by 60. So the ratio is 2 is to 1. That means 2 parts should be taken from first cask and 1 part should be taken from the second cask to get this mixture. Okay, I hope you are clear. Now friends, once again, you just try this problem and match your answer with mine. It is quite similar to the previous two problems. So I think after this particular problem, your concept to deal with this sort of problem will be better cleared. Now, cask A contains wine and water in the ratio 6:7 and cask B in the ratio 9:4. Okay, now let's take the wine part in the entire part, that is 6 by 13. So in cask A, wine is 6 by 13. In cask B, wine is 9 by 13. And what we want, in the final mixture, the wine part should be 8 by 13. Very simple, all the 13s will get cancelled. So it is 1:2. Very simple problem. I hope your answer is matching with mine. Now let's do this problem. In a mixture of 60 liters, the ratio of milk and water is 2:1. The ratio of milk and water is to be 1:2. Then the amount of water to be further added is. Friends, in existing mixture, the water is 1 by 3. Okay, and we are going to add water as 1. That means we are going to add 100% pure water. And the fraction part of 100% pure water is 1. And in the final mixture, we want the water to be 2 by 3. Okay, so very simple, it's 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3, it's 1 by 3, and it's 2 by 3, 1 minus 2 by 3, it is 1 by 3. That means the ratio is 1:1. That means if it is 60 liters, that means this mixture is 60 liters, then we have to add 60 liters of pure water to get the mixture. This mixture. Okay. I hope you are getting my point. Alternatively, you can do this problem by ratio and proportion technique also. Friends, in this case, the milk and water ratio is 2:1. And the desired ratio is milk and water to be 1:2. That means it is 2:4. This is the desired ratio. This is the present ratio. That means milk should be 2, but water should be increased by 3 parts. Okay, existingly water is 1 part. Now we want water to be 4 part. That means 3 part increment. Now, what is 3 part? This is total 3 part, 2 plus 1. And this total is 60. That means 3 part is 60. So how much water to be added? That is 3 part and 3 part is 60. That means 60 liters of water should be added. So no paperwork is required at all. And we have discussed two techniques to solve this particular problem. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this question. How much pure alcohol has to be added to 400 milliliter of a solution containing 15% alcohol to change the concentration of alcohol in the mixture 32%? Okay. As of now, it is 15%. We have to add 100% alcohol, that is pure alcohol, and we wish to get a concentration 32%. Okay, so just write the difference. So it is 4:1. That means 4 part of this particular alcohol to be added to 1 part of pure alcohol. So if it is 400 ml, it should be 100 ml. Okay, so we need to add 100 ml. So we'll be getting this concentration. Okay. Now let's see this question. Friends, I would recommend you to solve it on your own. Milk contains 5% water. What quantity of pure milk should be added to 10 liters of milk to reduce this to 2%? As of now, this milk contains 5% water. That means as of now, the purity of the milk is 95%. And we have to add pure milk. That means 100% milk. And we want the new milk to be of 98% since the water content should be 2%. Okay. So just find the difference. It is 3, it is 2. That means in 2:3 ratio we have to add. Okay. Now for every 3 part of pure milk is required. So for 10 part, if it is 10, it will be 15. Okay. So we need to add 15 liters of pure milk to this 10 liters of milk. So we'll be getting the milk content is 98% and water content is 2%. Okay. Now let's see this interesting question. In some quantity of ghee, 60% is pure ghee and 40% is vanaspati. If 10 kg of pure ghee is added, then the strength of vanaspati ghee becomes 20%. We have to find out the original quantity of ghee. Okay. So as of now, the pure ghee is 60% and we are adding pure ghee. That is the consistency of pure ghee in pure ghee is 100%, and in our final mixture the quantity of vanaspati ghee is 20%. That means 80% is pure ghee. Okay, so in all these three datas we have taken pure ghee into consideration. Okay, so it's 20, that means 1:1 ratio. That means if pure ghee is one part, this particular ghee should also be one part. So if we are adding 10 kilogram pure ghee, that means the initial quantity was also 10 kilogram. Okay, so it's 10 kilogram. I hope you are clear. Now let's see the total population of a village is 5000. The number of males and females increases by 10% and 15% respectively, and consequently the population of the village becomes 5600. That means 600 is increasing. What was the number of males in the village? Okay, that means we have to find out the breakup of 5000 in males and females. Okay, now how could we solve this problem through allegation method? Let's assume the entire population is of males. Okay, if the entire population is of males and number of males are increases by 10%, that means the increment is 10% of 5000, that is 500. Okay, now let's assume all of these are females. Okay, so in case females are increasing by 15%, that means the total increment must be 15% of 5000, that is 750. But what is actual increase? It is 600. Okay, so it is the mean value. Okay, I hope you are getting my point. By this we'll be getting the ratio of males and females. So it is 150 and it is 100. So it is 3:2 ratio. That means 3000 and 2000. 3000 males and 2000 females. I hope you are getting my point. If you wish to cross verify, you can. 3000 males are there and they are getting increased by 10%. That means 300. And 2000 females are there and 15% is increment. So further 300. So in all, 600 are getting increased, which is 5600. Okay, so very smartly we can do this problem in seconds. I hope you are getting my point. Now let's see this question. Arun purchased 30 kilogram of wheat at the rate of rupees 11.5 per kilogram and 20 kilogram of wheat at the rate of 14.25 per kilogram. He mixed the two and sold the mixture. Approximately what price per kilogram should he sell the mixture to make 30% profit? Friends, first of all, let's find out the per kilogram cost price. Okay, of we can say the mixture. So 30 kilogram at 11.5, that is 30 into 11.5 plus 20 kilogram at 14.25 divided by total quantities 50 kilogram. So we'll be getting the price per kilogram, that is cost price per kilogram. Okay. So it is 630 by 50, or we can say 63 by 5. Now we wish to have a profit of 30%. This is our cost price. So to make 30% profit, the selling price must be 1.3 times this. Okay. 63 by 5 into 1.3 times. Okay. So we'll be getting the price per kilogram. That is the selling price per kilogram. It's around 16.4. Okay. So the closest option is 16.30. I hope you are getting my point. Now let's see this question of profit and loss. Padam purchased 30 kilogram of rice at the rate 17.5 per kilogram and another 13 kilogram. That means the quantity is same over here. He mixed the two and sold the entire quantity at the rate of 18.6 per kilogram and made 20% overall profit. At what price per kilogram did he purchase the lot of another 30 kilogram rice? Since the quantity is same, that means we are mixing both of them in equal quantity. Okay. Now, first of all, find the price of the cost price of the entire lot per kilo. Okay. So it is 18.6 is the selling price divided by 1.2. That is the profit part. We'll be getting the cost price. Okay. So the mean cost price is 18.6 divided by 1.2. We can say it is 31 by 2. Okay. Now, this is the mean cost price of the mixture. Now, some part is 17.5 cost price and some portion is X, we don't know. And the mean is 15.5. Okay, now definitely this is bigger than this. That means this will be smaller than this. So here it will be 15.5 minus x and here it is 2. Now both of them are same since both of them are, we are mixing in equal ratio or equal quantity. That means 15.5 minus x is equal to 2. That means x is equal to, just a moment. That means x is equal to 13.5. That is the price of unknown. Okay. So the 50% is 17.5 and the other is 13.5. I hope you are getting my point. Now let's see this question. A person pays rupees 6.4 per liter of milk. He adds water and sells the mixture at rupees 8 per liter, thereby making 37.5% profit. The proportion of water to milk received by customer is. Okay, now this is the cost price and this is the selling price. In this selling price, 37.5% profit is included. Now friends, what is 37.5% in terms of fraction? Friends, you must be knowing 75% is 3 by 4. 75% is 3 by 4 and it is half of 75%, that means it is 3 by 8. Okay, now this is selling price, this is profit. So we can find out the mean cost price, that means the cost price of this mixture. Okay, so SP by CP is equal to 1 plus 3 by 8, that means we can say selling price is 11 by 8 of cost price. Now, friends, it is mean cost price, not this cost price, but the cost price of the mixture. Okay, now selling price is 8 rupees per liter. That means mean cost price is 64 by 11. Okay. Now, price of this milk is 6.4. Then we are adding water to it, and the price of water is 0, and the mean cost price is 64 by 11. Here it is 64 by 10. Okay, so it is milk, it is water. So we'll be getting milk to water ratio from this calculation. Okay, so it is 64 by 10 minus 64 by 11, and it is 64 by 11. Okay, so it is, just a moment. It is 64, we can take it as common, 11 minus 10, that is 1. So it is 64 by 110, and it is 64 by 11, or we can say 640 by 110. That means the ratio is 640 by 64, or we can say 10 is to 1. It's milk, it's water. Okay. So the proportion of water to milk is 1 is to 10. Okay. Which is this option. I'm sure you're getting my point, and the problem is actually very simple. Now let's see this question. A man purchased sugar worth rupees 400. He sold 3/4 at a loss of 10% and the remainder at a gain of 10%. That means 1/4 at a gain of 10%. On the whole, he gets profit or loss. What? We have to find out. Okay. Now, some quantity is being sold at 10% profit and some quantity is being sold at 10% loss. So in case of loss, we put a minus sign over here. Okay. So overall, we don't know what is loss or profit. Let it be X. Okay. And ratio of these two is, this is 3/4 quantity he's selling at 10% loss. That means this is 3/4 quantity and this is 1/4 quantity. It is 3/4 and it is 1/4. Okay. Definitely 10 will be greater than X. So it is 10 minus X, and it is X minus minus 10. That means it is X plus 10. So X is the overall profit or loss. So 10 minus X upon X plus 10 is equal to, it is in this ratio, that is 3 by 4 is to 1 by 4. Or we can say 3 by 4 divided by 1 by 4, that is 3. Now let's calculate X. So it is 10 minus X is equal to 3X plus 30. That means 4x is equal to minus 20. That means x is equal to minus 5. If x is negative, that means overall there is a loss, which is 5%. Okay. So very simple problem. Or you can calculate it quickly and easily. Friends, in profit loss problem, do not forget to put this minus sign if there is a loss. And overall, you are getting a negative sign. So definitely there is a loss. If you are getting a positive sign over here, then definitely there is a profit. Okay. So just be careful about it. Now let's see this question. A businessman sold 2/3 of his stock at a gain of 20% and the rest at a gain of 14%. The overall percentage of gain to the businessman is, okay. Now some portion is at 20%, rest at 14%, and overall it is X, okay, which we have to find out. Now this is 2/3 stock and this is 1/3 stock. That means the ratio between these two is 2:1. Now X is, this is the bigger one. So X must be smaller than this and bigger than this. So it is 20 minus X and it is X minus 14. Okay, now X minus 14 over 20 minus X is 2:1. Okay, now just calculate it for X. So it is 3X is equal to 40 plus 1/4, that is 54. That means X is equal to 18%. That means overall profit is 18%. Okay. Alternatively, Let's divide the stock in three, one third part. It is one third, one third, and one third. Now, one third is at 20%. This one third is also at 20%, since two third is at 20%, and this one third is 14%. So the total is 20 plus 20 plus 14 divided by 3. So 20 plus 20, 40, and 14, 54 divided by 3. That is 18%. You can do the problem like this also. It's quite simple. Now let's see this question. A person purchases 90 clocks and sells 40 clocks at a gain of 10% and 50 clocks at a gain of 20%. If he sold all of them at a uniform profit of 15%, then he would have got 40 rupees less. The cost price of each clock is. Friends, first of all, let's find out the average gain. Okay, so 40 clocks at a gain of 10%, that is this. Plus 50 clocks at a gain of 20% divide by total 90 clocks. So it is 400 plus 1000, that is 1400 by 90, or we can say 140 by 9% is the average gain in first case. Okay. In the second case, the profit is 15%. Okay. Now let's say the cost price of the of 90 clocks is X. Okay, and difference between these two is 40. So it is 140 by 9% minus 15% is 40. Okay. Sorry, it is 100. And it is 15 into 9, then it must be 900. So x into 15 9s are 135. 140 minus 135 is 5 by 900 is equal to 40. So x is equal to 7200. That means the total cost price of 90 clocks is 7200. And for one piece, it must be 7200 by 90. That is 80. Very simple problem. Friends, you might have enjoyed this session. We'll be doing more such problems in our next session of allegation. Till then, do revise this session and the previous session. Bye-bye.